Hello, grade 5 children. In today's session, we are going to see pages 108 to 113 in your studio book. So now just take page number 108 in your studio book. See 4.12. Read out the question. Mr. Wagrekar sells tickets at the Dombivli station in Mumbai. Since his job involves a lot of money, he has to be very careful with his calculations. So very careful means definitely we have to calculate very accurately. Ticket calculation will be very accurate, and here 233,428 passengers travel through Dombivli daily. One third of them buy their tickets at the counter. So one third of them buy their tickets at the counter. How many passengers buy tickets every day? So you know very well, every is a keyword for division. Okay, so that's why we are going to do division here, and we have to calculate accurately. So it's a normal division. And we can't go with 2 because it is less than 3, so I just taken 2 digit number. So 23 minus 21 gives the answer 2. Then bring down the next digit, it is 3. And how many 3s are there in 23? It is 7. So 7 3s are 21. So 3 minus 1 is 2. Then bring down 4. So how many 3s are there in 24? Yes, 8 3s are 24. After doing subtraction, we have to bring down the next digit because 24 minus 24 is 0. Then bring down 2. 2 is less than 3, so we have to put 0 in the quotient place. And I have to bring down the next digit 8. So before itself, I put 9 here. So 9 3s are 27. Right. So after doing subtraction, the remainder is 1. Now what is the quotient? Yes, it is 77,809. So now just move on to the next page. Round off 233,428 to the nearest 10 to check the answer. So nearest 10. So we have to round off the digit in the tens place and underline the digit in the ones place. So after that, you got the answer is 233,430. Yes. Now just don't bother about the place value. Now we are going to divide this number by 3. So how many 3s are in 23? Again 21. 7 3s are 21. So after subtracting, you got 2. Then bring down 3. Then again 7 3s are 21. Then 23 minus 21, we got the answer as 2. Then you have to bring down the next digit 4. So 8 3s are, yes, it is 24. So after writing, we have to do the subtraction. So it will be 0. Then bring down the next digit 3. So 1 times 3. So I just put 1 in the 10th place. Then 3 minus 3, 0. So I am just bringing down the next digit 0. And here 0 is less than 3. So we have to put 0 in the quotient place. So 0 into 3, 3. So this is the answer. So what's your quotient? 77,810. So see the next question. Rupees 14,94,528 is collected as a ticket money daily. How much is collected by each ticket counter? If there are 16 such counters. So 16 such counters in kuduthirukanga. So we are going to split up the money into 16 counters. So we have to do the division. So here I can't take 14 because 14 is less than 16. So I just taken 3 numbers here. So 9 into 16, you will get the answer as 144. And after doing subtraction, 5, then bring down 4. And how many 16s are there in 54? So next, 3 times 16, we got the answer as 48. Now if you do subtraction, you will get the answer as 6. Now just bring down the next digit. How many 4s are there in 65? 4 times. So 4 into 16, 64. So 65 minus 64, 1. Then I just brought down the next digit 12. So it is less than 16. So we have to put 0 in the quotient place. Then bring down the next digit 8. And how many 16s are there in 128? So 8 16s are 128. So what is 128 minus 128? Yes, it is 0. Now just move on to the next page. Again, Mr. Wagrekar shares his counter with his friend. So, friend oda share pandraru, who works during the evening shift. Each of them handle about 93,408. So, it's divided among 2 persons, right? So, divided by 2. So, first write down the dividend in the dividend place. So, 93,408 divided by 2. Yes, 4 2s are 8. So, 9 minus 8, 1. Then bring down 3. Then 6 2s are 12. Then, after doing subtraction, the answer is 1. Then bring down 4. Then 7 2s are 14. Then bring down 0 again. So 0 is less than 2. So put 0 in the quotient place. Then bring down 8. So how many 2s are there in 8? 4 2s are 8. So the answer is 46,704. So you have to write the answer in the dash. I didn't write here. So next question is for your self-work. Read out and answer it. So move on to the next page. Now just move on to the next page, 4.13. Look within. You now know that approximation can be used as a way to check your answer. So here you have to write three places. When will you use this method for checking the calculation? So you have to mention the three places along in the dash where we are using the approximation. Now just take the next page, Think and Ink, 4.14. Some facts about a library are given. So library la usually nariya books irukum. Read them and answer the following questions in the table. Make approximate calculations to check your solutions. So we are going to answer the following question, and also we are going to find out the approximation by rounding off numbers to the highest place. The Anna library has 9 floors and a capacity to store total capacity is 11,57,912 books. At present, it has a collection of 5,50,000 books. At present, ivlo dhaan irukku and is visited by 2,865 people every day. So in this question, in this passage, you have to remember the numbers which is given here, because we are going to do the calculation within that. So see the first question. If each book is valued at ₹500, here these many number of books are present. So each book is ₹500. What is the total value of all the books in the library? So to find out the total value for these many books, we have to do multiplication. So the number is 5,50,000 books into ₹500. So I'll do the direct multiplication. So what is 5 into 5? It is 25. And remainder 2. So carry over in that place. So 5 is 25 plus 2, 27. And here above 4 zeros, and again I'm just adding 2 zeros. After that, you just insert the commas in an appropriate place. So this is the answer. Next, we have to calculate the approximate calculation. So I'm just rounding off to the highest place. So 5,50,000 will become as 6 lakh. So into 500, if you round off, you will get the answer as 500. And here 6 5s are 30. So I'm just multiplying directly and I'm just adding the zeros here. So totally 7 zeros. Yes, after that, insert the commas. Next, if each floor had an equal number of books. So here 9 floors are there and we are going to split the books into 9 floors. So splitting in each floor means we have to do division. So the present book is the present book is 5,50,000. So it is divided by 9. So after dividing, you will be getting the answer like this. So next part is for you. After rounding of 5,50,000, you will get the answer as 6 lakh. Then by rounding of 9, you will get the answer as 10. So you have to do the division in this box. Now just move on to the next page. How many new books can be added based on its capacity? So first we have to see what is the capacity of the library. See the before page. The total capacity is 11,57,912. But already at present, 5,50,000 books are there. We have to find out remaining how many books can hold in the library. So to find out the remaining, we have to do the subtraction, right? Yes, you just do the subtraction here. You have to do the subtraction in between these number 2 minus 0 2, 1 minus 0 1, 9 minus 0 9, 7 minus 0 7. Then this will be your answer. You know subtraction very well. I think no need of any explanation. We have to calculate the approximate calculation. So if you round off this number, what will be your answer? Yes, this is your approximate value. Yes, just see, if you round off this number, you will get the zeros after 1. These many zeros you have to put right, because 1 is less than 5. So then if you round off 5,50,000, you will get the answer as 6 lakh. So what is now 10 lakh minus 6 lakh? Yes, the answer is 4 lakh. There is a vast difference between 6 lakh and 4 lakh, but no issues, it's not a problem. It's an approximate value. Now just read out the next question and answer in the box. And do this as a self-work in your studio book. Thank you children, we'll meet in our next class.